For decades, NASA has been the world's most prominent space agency. Since first landing astronauts on the moon in 1969, it's launched all manner of probes, rovers, and shuttles out of Earth's atmosphere and into the great unknown. But of course, there are mysteries still yet to be solved on our own planet. So what would happen if NASA turned its attention to those? This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if NASA explored the ocean instead?
Are you a fiend for facts? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more fascinating content.
It doesn't have quite as high a profile as NASA, but there's already a major US government agency dedicated to exploring the ocean, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, otherwise known as NOAA, which is a pretty great name. Among its many responsibilities, NOAA is tasked with studying the ocean and finding ways to protect it. We know that 71% of the Earth's surface is covered in water, and that 96% of that water is found in the oceans. So we're dealing with a truly incredible space here, home to millions of animals and life forms, and according to some theories, the place where all life on Earth started. It's amazing, and a little depressing then, that today more than 80% of the ocean remains unexplored. There's still so much that we don't know. Reasons for that lack of exploration can be found in the budget. While NASA received $23.2 billion worth of funding for the year 2021, NOAA received $5.4 billion. If we take only the cold, stark fiscal figures then, we could say that the US government essentially provides ocean exploration with less than one quarter the financial backing that it does for space. Of course, in reality, it's perhaps not as simple as all that. But for the purposes of today's video, it's interesting to imagine what we could achieve if the mighty NASA swapped stars for starfish. In a manner of speaking, we can find some hints as to what might happen in various existing initiatives where NASA and NOAA have already partnered up. Most crossover studies today involve NASA making use of NOAA weather satellites, which monitor everything from tropical storms to melting ice caps. We know, thanks to various headline-making missions, that NASA is now a dab hand at mapping moons and other planets. The Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter, for example, has captured high-definition images reportedly covering 99% of the surface of Mars. So if NASA explored the oceans instead, we might expect similarly sharp maps of the waters around us, allowing scientists to focus in on any one square mile, or even square meter, of ocean topography, perhaps even in real time. If four times the funding were to amount to four times the coverage of our seas from above, then it could mean better than ever wave monitoring, weather predictions, coastal erosion tracking, and even ship and plane tracking, potentially making shipwrecks and downed planes far easier to find too. But of course, that opening statistic that more than 80% of the ocean remains unexplored doesn't, for the most part, relate to the surface water. And indeed, through various projects in the past, NASA has had a helping hand in charting our seas before now. But where it could really make a difference in ocean study is beneath the waves. Dr. Jean Carl Feldman is an oceanographer currently working with NASA. In June 2020, though, he spoke to Emily Petzko at the nonprofit conservation group Oceana to explain why ocean exploration has so far been so limited. According to Feldman, it's arguably easier to send people to space than it is to the seafloor, thanks to the, quote, intense pressures in the deep ocean. Feldman goes on to show that, for a dive to the bottom of the Mariana Trench, the deepest part of the ocean, it's, quote, 1,000 times more pressure than at the surface, which is the equivalent of the weight of 50 jumbo jets. Of course, on a mission into the vacuum of space, it's adjusting to low air pressure that's usually the problem. So if NASA turned its gaze inwards, then it would mean inverting a lot of its tech. But we've shown time and again in recent history that it can be done. In 1960, we saw the first crewed submersible, the Trieste, reach Challenger Deep, the deepest part of the Mariana Trench. In 2012, there was the first solo voyage to the same region, a high-profile mission piloted by the film director James Cameron on board the deep-sea Challenger vessel. Then, in 2018, the explorer Victor Vescovo piloted the limiting factor submersible to the deepest part of the Atlantic Ocean, in the Puerto Rico Trench. It was the first stage in his pioneering Five Deeps expedition, which saw him visit the deepest parts of all the world's oceans. With these success stories in mind, then, it's perhaps a little frustrating that we haven't gone further. One issue is that all deep-sea missions are severely limited by time. James Cameron's voyage on Deep Sea Challenger, for example, set various time duration records, but the filmmaker was still only able to explore for about 3 hours. By comparison, the Apollo 11 moon landing saw astronauts Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin spend more than 21 hours on the lunar surface, including about 2.5 hours outside of the module. Perhaps, then, if NASA were to go underwater in earnest, we would eventually see an equivalent achievement, a long-stay submersible rooted to the ocean floor with technology to allow oceanauts to leave their vessel for first-hand exploration. What's perhaps more likely, though, is that with a NASA-sized budget behind it, agencies like NOAA could deploy more and more uncrewed vehicles to get a better picture of what lies beneath. In 2019, the Ocean Discovery X Prize was contested by a number of groups, all striving to build robots to map the ocean floor. Meanwhile, there are initiatives like Seabed 2030, which aims to map 100% of the seafloor by 2030, as well as the 30 by 30 campaign, which aims to protect 30% of the world's oceans by the same year. We've had remote-controlled deep-sea vehicles for a number of decades now, but there are few machines to match the scope and capabilities of NASA's various probes, rovers, and orbiters in space. If there were multiple vehicles at this level, working round the clock underwater and directed by specialists behind computer screens on dry land, then we could quickly get to know the sea just as well as we know the moon or Mars. What's perhaps most significant to realize, however, is that in many ways, ocean exploration and space discovery are one and the same thing. So the question at the top of today's video doesn't actually require such an extreme change of direction. In recent years, astrobiologists have already turned to the sea in search for answers, particularly when it comes to the search for aliens. Up until the 1970s, around the time when we first started using remote-controlled robots in the ocean, there had been a general idea that there couldn't be much by the way of life surviving down there. Today, of course, we know that there's so much life in even the deepest parts of the ocean thanks to our so far limited attempts to explore it, and that revelation has forced us to rethink what's possible. The parameters for life have already been drastically altered thanks to ocean study, then, which has already had an impact on how we view space. Astrobiologists are today particularly interested in the possibility of subsurface oceans across various solar system locations, including the gas giant moons of Titan, Enceladus, and Europa. It's thought that if there is alien life close to us, then these bodies of water are probably the best bet for where it could be hiding. It makes sense, then, that before we can even hope to explore unknown oceans elsewhere in the solar system, we should really get to grips with our own. More than that, though, when it comes to our current deep-sea missions, it's so often the case that they report back findings of all new, never-before-seen species. New types of deep-sea worm, or fish, or octopus. In many ways, these are already alien creatures to our eyes. They've evolved to live and thrive in a truly extreme environment, and NASA researchers can learn a huge amount of information from how these creatures work. Information that could be used to hunt biosignatures away from Earth, yes, but also to develop novel ways for humans to survive in similarly extraordinary places. So ultimately, it'd be a success on two fronts. We still know so little about the oceans that are all around us, but NASA could dramatically improve our understanding if it were to turn its full attention to them. And comprehensive ocean maps spanning from the surface to the deepest depths would surely become some of our most valuable scientific tools. Equally, though, if the world's leading space agency paid closer attention to the sea, and if greater funding was pledged to ocean study in general, then we could quickly make massive strides toward comprehending the rest of space as well. And that's what would happen if NASA studied the ocean instead.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.